Boys, I have a special one for you today. We're going to be reviewing both Kroos, Benedetto. I'm going to be building new teams around them, and we're going to be having a lot of hella fun. So first, let's talk about Kroos. Oh my God, Crunch, you're not going to try the car, blah, 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 blah. Everyone always says that. I put a review and I don't try the car. It's fine, bro. At the end of the day, there is people that actually do reviews trying these cars, and I just watch their review and then come and tell you what they thought about it. So in this case, I watch Inception, and what Inception said about this guy mainly is that he is a great card, insane card. He fits the meta, not perfectly, but well enough for you to consider completing him. The only thing, the only, like, say, downside of him is I think he does not have a finesse shot trait, which is a nail, especially when you have someone with 94 long shots and 98 shot power, because if you cannot shoot, like, you can do long shots, but you know long shots this game are not that good. And mainly if you want to shoot outside of the box, which is, I think, the most, like, nice thing about this card, you clearly can't, because, well, finesse shots are not that great, and, well, if you don't have the finesse shot trait, and shooting outside of the box, just down straight, a long shot in FIFA 21 is just dead. But well, it is what it is. Next, pace. For me, 88 pace is not good enough, but honestly, for most people that are below Division 3, this is gonna be sick. My issue with the card is 300k price tag. If you have fodder and you can make it 100k or something like that, then it's perfect. But overall, for me, this is a card that, even though it looks stacked in stats, and it's a sentiment that will clearly, if you give him the ball, he will distribute it left, right, middle, center, whatever, and you're gonna have a ton of fun with him. I just personally think that if you're taking the game seriously, this is a card that you should stay away from and just go for that De Jong. You know, you can just go and if you get a card like De Jong, or, well, actually, he has a lot of similar cards. Like, this Neos is, well, yeah, this is interesting. Like, overall, if you were to compare him to someone like Hullet, you'd be like, oh, wow, him and Hullet have so many similarities with this and that. It's just, I think this is a card that you more than likely will upgrade from in the close future, and there is a lot of alternatives in La Liga. It's not like La Liga lacks sentiments. Look, if we literally look at this together, you can see that there is, well, Herrera is already finished, but where was him? And there was Jong. Okay, there we go. I don't know why he didn't appear before. But first, there is the Jong team of the week, which, you know, 86 rated, 160k. He will do the job at passing the ball. He won't be able to score, but that extra pace would be sick, and he's tradable. Then you have players like Llorente, who are not responsible. They're still pacey. You have players like Valverde, who are not responsible. They're still pacey. So you can even use Cucurella as a sentiment in game. You know what I'm saying? He's free, like this one or the other one. They're free cards at the end of the day. So, well, it is what it is. If you want to go for Kroos, go for Kroos. I just wanted to give my 5 cents, whatever, here. Let me build you a team around them. I'm not going to go like that crazy. Normally, I build you like 1,000 teams. This time, more than likely, we're going to go with a sweaty... Well, if you're completing Kroos, I guess the main way you're going to use him is by, well, first, your left back is going to be Mendy, and then your center back is going to be Varane. Again, at the end of the day, if you don't want to use these two, you use Jimenez and Torreira. Just ignore these two. Instead of them, do Jimenez, Torreira, done. Then your keeper, I personally love Oblak. I think Oblak is certainly the best keeper I've used in this game. Like, honestly, bro, I've used Oblak and it... I have nothing but praise for this guy. He's sick. I love him. I love him to bits. I think you can actually pair him up with Jimenez. Because why not? Why not? Like, Jimenez and Hiva have a strong link, and then you can put basically... if you wanted to go for like a La Liga sort of thing. So first we're going to do a La Liga, and then I'm going to do a Bundesliga. Because he's, you know, he's German, and it'd be nice for me to build you a Bundesliga team around this guy. So you do Jimenez, then your right back. I think the league, La Liga, lacks right backs that are actually like accessible for you. I think this new Lucas Vazquez is absolutely and brutally underrated. This guy with a shadow, you play him in a 4-2-3-1 formation, in a 5-defender formation, this guy right wing back, that's insane. But if you don't want that, what you can do, and what I would advise most people to do, is you just have a left back and then use Mendy as a right back, because I know this league has a lot of left backs. You can do Torreira. Yeah, look at this. Like, you can do Torreira with him, and then Varane and Mendy on the right side, and then you can literally do whatever you want after you put Hazard into the team. You can do whatever you want. I still think Hazard is a great card. I've used him. I love them. These four can be anything you want, but if I'm honest with you, I think La Liga has a lot of good players. I would recommend, right next to Kroos, what I would recommend is a player like Valverde. Why? Well, Kroos lacks a little bit of pace, and that's a fact. So if you want to make up for that lack of pace with someone that has more pace and can, you know, he still can defend, he will stay down the back, and he will make sure that when you recover, it's fine. You should be fine. You should be fine. I think this is the absolute best partnership you can go for here. Now I'm going to show you one in like a different league and whatever, in case you want, you're interested in that, then you're striker. If you completed your Felix, that would be insane. If you didn't, then that's a nail, because most of the other cards are in Liga. You could go for Isaac. I think Isaac is not about, honestly speaking, I think this Isaac is not a bad card. If you completed Dembele, another card that you can definitely put up there. I tried that Isaac. He was, you know, he wasn't good, but he wasn't dead. Oh, this Kubo is such a nice card, boys. I really enjoy this Kubo. I think I really had a ton of fun with this Kubo. Of course, if you want to go for like usability and like meta and, you know, sweatiness, you go for Dembele. But honestly, boys, I had so much fun with this Kubo. He's dribbling, because I think he has a unique body type, because EA loves him. I know he has lean, but because he's lean, he's short, he has good agility, balance. Man, this guy, I had him with like Maestro, I think, like the you know, this is what I put on him, and he was so good. I recommend like Hunter, bro. This is such a good card. And then here in sentiment, you need someone who can play up front, so we could put Isaac there for a set. You saw it's easier for us to look at a striker. You could go forward, and normally what I tell you to do is put a left forward as a striker there, but yeah, you can go for Felix. There you go. Sentiment, and then that's your full-on attack. If I'm honest with you, there is something else you could do that's a little bit crazy. You could play a striker who has a little bit of defending. I don't know whom, though, from in here. You could even go for off-league. If you had this guy, yeah, he would be a sick left wing-back. There is a lot of players, and you can try and find them and play them left wing-back. I know it's going to be rough. There is not that many great ones. Well, what you could do is you could play Ocampos. You could play this Ocampos, and you could play him left wing-back with a shadow one. You could put a shadow one and play him left wing-back, and then he's your left wing-back, and then this Lucas Vazquez is your right wing-back. Something like that. Again, you know, it's up to you, whatever you want to do, but I think this is a great card for right wing-back. Now, as I said, oh, boys, yeah, I'm going to make you one with on a different league. I think you can keep the defense. I actually, now that I'm looking at it, I think for the price, for 1 million coins, well, because, well, of course, it's 1 million coins if you add him, but for 650, I think this is a really nice and solid looking defense. So what we can do here is go for the extra players, and I always tell you, just go for Vinjeda, bro. It's such a nice and reliable card. And then you can go for Renato, which again is such a nice and reliable card. And this is new David that has a green link to Renato, which is again another such a nice and reliable card. You have a green link here, he's on cam, and then you can basically put from this league any right winger. Sadly, you can put Golovin, and then you can play a three-man midfielding game, or you can go and you can grab a right back who can play striker, or even you could go crazy and you could go Cucurella here, bro. I'm so good at building teams. You could go crazy and put Cucurella in there, and then in game, you can play him left back, you can play him right back, and then you can play Cucurella, like, I don't know, bro. Cam, striker, left winger, right winger, bro. There is so many things you can do with this Golovin. I love cards like him, who, like, you just put a shadow on, lad, and this guy is right back 100%. He can do it. 78 pace with 78 defending with 92 stamina, good passing, good pace, good, workers are fine, lean body type's not the greatest, but overall he's a sick card. And if any, and you can do the other card that he has, what's the name, Golovin, as a right wing back. This, you can do that one as a right winger, like this off cam or whatever, can you put it, there you go, off cam, whatever, bro. This, I know that sick card. Cool. Done. We did Kroos. Let's go for Darío Benedetto. I wanted to do 2-in-1 video to get out of the way. I think Benedetto is an absolute... Where's my water? Oh, I didn't bring water well. I think Benedetto is an absolutely underrated beast. My issue with him is his body type is average. I think the workers are perfect to be up front. You know, high, low means that he won't come back or defend ever. So you can have him as a lone striker. Perfect. With engine, I still think, even though you look at that 92 dribbling, you're like, oh my god, 92 dribbling, wow, he's got it, go with it. Well, no. Average body type means that if he doesn't have literally 96 dribbling, he's not going to feel like Ben Yedder on the ball. He needs a lean body type to feel like Ben Yedder on the ball, which is unfortunate, but at the same time, it's fine. You know, it's a good car, it's free. Just cost you your time. We're going to build one. And you can actually, if I'm honest with you, you could have Benedetto. Bro, I am so smart. You could literally put Benedetto into this team. look at our multitasking abilities. You can put Benedetto into this team. Let's see if Benedetto has like a... I mean, if you don't mind, you can always go for SANSON, whom I tried and it wasn't that bad. And then you can take him out. Keep these like that, and then put Hiovo Verde, so you make up for the lack of pace in this guy. There you go. And then your right winger can be, I don't know, bro. In this league, again, they lack a little bit of right wingers, but you can always go for a left winger changed to right winger. So what I normally do is I do Bamba, bro. Why not, man? This guy, 84 rated. It's not a bad card after all. You play him off cam, left winger. Beautiful. You can do that. Now, I wanted to continue with my view on Benedetto. I think he's absolutely beautiful. I just don't like the responsiveness. I've seen the videos. He doesn't seem that responsive. You then, yeah, that he's going to be still better than him. But for a free card, if you don't use skills, I think he's a great card. Again, go ahead. You do this. If you want to go for a different right side, I always go for, like, I like the Neuer. I think the Neuer is a great card. And I also think, you know, 80 pace is beautiful, lovely. You can always go for these Florenzi. You can go for a Tau. Who else was there? There is a silver objective card that's like 74 rated and looks decent. This Aguilar, I think this Florenzi, even if you could, if I'm honest with you, I'll play Pavard right back and play Florenzi sentiment. I know I'm crazy, bro. I'm crazy. That's why some people don't like to watch me, because I'm just crazy and I tell you the weirdest combinations on earth. And then your keeper, oh wow, oh, he needs a green link. I was so excited, bros. I was like, oh my god, I found something that no one has found before. But this guy, if you didn't get the Chiglio, But at the end of the day, you can always go for Golovin, lad. You can just go for Golovin in that position, off cam, three. And then, oh, right, yeah, I said this too many times. You put Aguilar there with Golovin and you got this. Why not? You know what? Why not? If you want to go and you don't want to go La Liga and you want to go, oh, wow, you know, wow, I want to get a complete Ligue 1 squad. Okay, so as always, you go Renato. It's just you like this, the best player in this league. I've said it since the start. Your center back, again, you can do the player that I showed you. Well, you can do Golovin as a right back. And then you can easily do the Neuer, who I am really a huge fan of. More than likely, you already have to deal. If you're completing this card, more than likely, you have to deal on your team. I think Navas doesn't look like a bad card, honestly. You already should have Todibo, so maybe put Todibo. If not, you have Volan. If not, you have too many options. Like, you can do whatever you want, honestly, here. And personally, to save coins, I'll put Golovin as a centre-back. Or maybe I'll bring, like, I don't know, this Traore as a centre-back. He has good defending in that. Then the left-back position, you can do a Mavi. You can do Camara. I use Camara. I liked him. So why not? I'll put Camara. Your left-winger, as we have seen before, I think I tried Ekambi. He was not good. I did not like him. I'll personally tell you to stay away from him. I think Bamba is sick. This upgraded Bamba is overpriced as hell. So the 84 is fine. Actually, doesn't he have an 86? I thought he had a regular 86. Oh no, this one was 86 and then they got like the thingy. Okay, so you can do him. Then you have a center mid, you have a striker, you have another striker in case you need him. You can play him on the wing if you want. He's a winger. We need another center mid in this league. And I think they do. I personally love Fabregas. I love like the card. I love everything about the card. I don't know if you guys like him or not. I'm going to personally put him because I love him. If you have Bruno, you can do Bruno. If you want Rafinha, you can do Rafinha. If you want something else, you can do something else. I just absolutely and brutally love Fabregas. And then, actually, instead of that, just to, yeah, you know, why not? You put Golovin and Sanchez in midfield. So you have a really nice, decent up passing. One strong, the other one is not strong, I guess. I was going to say, like, responsive, but both should indeed be a little bit, you know, decent on the ball. And then you can put Andre in there. You can put Andre in there. He has decent dribbling, even though in game it doesn't translate, like, a lot of decent dribbling, if I'm honest with you. But, or you can go for a striker. If you're lucky enough, you could have Mbappe. You could do the pie if you like him. I personally don't like him, so I wouldn't do the pie. You can do Bolan looks sick. Oh, Bolaya, bro. This Bolaya looks really nice, man. If you can bring Bolaya into your team, if you can do something like this for 700k, I think this is beautiful. I think this is beautiful. You have a lot of informed cards, a lot happening in here. Oh, you have two Golovins. Oh, wow. What have I just done? Well, this other center back can be Kimpembe. So you do this, bro. Center mid with center mid. This guy cam. This guy right wing, left wing, striker. And then you have a full on. Bro, this is beautiful. You can even play 4-2. You can play with like a five defender formation with Bamba left wing back. I think he can be a left wing back mainly because he has high work rates, which are perfect for the position. He does lack that stamina and the defending is dead, but you can do it if you want to. I wouldn't recommend it though. But well, love you all. See you all. I hope that you enjoyed. See you in the next one, baby.